actress that a sense in this beyond. You know what I'm talking about?
So talk to me, man. We doing the label thing, the CEO thing. You got artists under you. Break it all down for me, brother.
Yeah, man. We got the label. We got the compilation dropping June 2nd. It's a Veltri Music Group compilation. That's a new project that's going to be dropping. And, you know, just trying to really get through this quarantine, man. I was actually on my own tour, and we was doing a lot of dates. I think my last date was the City Winery, and I probably had still about 10 more dates I was doing. It was called the R&B Addiction Tour. It was by myself.
Yeah, the City Winery Tour. That's fire. Yeah.
Yeah.
I did a couple shows with Jonte Austin and Music Soul Child. Yeah. They was on that run too. Yeah, that's fire.
Yeah, so we was on that, man. And, you know, just to be, not to be able to travel, man, it's kind of, if you're used to doing something, you know what I'm saying? It's like when you're not doing it, things just don't feel right. So, you know, I've been trying to get through, like, the first month I was cool.
Right.
Now it's starting to get, like, damn, I'm starting to get, like, a little agitated because I'm ready to get back out there on that road.
Right.
So I at least have some excitement because I'm able to drop this new record.
Okay.
And, you know, I have a lot of focus on the label and on my new artist, Santo Silva and Zan Man Trippin'. So I'm excited about them. I'm excited about the compilation project that we're dropping June 2nd. Mm. Then later on in the year, we're going to all drop our solo projects as well.
Mm.
So, you know, I'm just trying to build a crew and build a clique, man, Veltri Music Group. I love how things are going right now. Looking for a dope female artist to you know, kind of just bring everything together. But right now, riding with the boys, and I'm excited about the new movement, man.
Mm. So tell me, man, like, because you've been an artist, and for those that don't know, me and this guy went to college together.
Yes, Clark Atlanta.
Clark Atlanta. Shout out Clark Atlanta. And it's funny, man. Like, even though we went to school, you know, I didn't really find out about Bobby V until I had a conversation with Shaka Zulu, and he brought me in to start producing all the mixtapes for the whole Disturbing the Peace brand.
Right.
He was telling me, he was like, yo, we about to expand, you know, beyond Ludacris. At the time, they had Ludacris, Shauna, I-20. They had that whole wave going on. And he was like,
Play a circle.
Shout out 2 Chainz, Titty Boy, of course, Dollar. He was like, we're gonna go do this whole R&B thing, and we got this cat, Bobby Valentino at the time.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Well, still.
Yeah.
And then, man, he played, man, listen. So this man played me this record, right? I'm not even gonna say, he just played me this record right here. And I was like, yo, what the fuck did y'all just sign? Who is this dude? Matter of fact, I'm gonna just do this.
Bobby Valentino. You know how we do. It's another one.
I started walking down the mailroads. You look like an angel. Drink powder. I was blown away by your sexiness. All I have to do is catch up to you. Slow down. I just want to get to know you. But don't turn around. Cause that pretty brown thing was good to me.
So he plays me so down, and he's like, this is the priority right now. We're going in this direction. I want you to do a mixtape. It was featuring you, and they had a female artist on their label. I can't remember.
Sharifa.
And I featured you and Sharifa. And I just remember, and Ludacris hosted it for me, man, and shouts out to them. And I just remember the wave that took over, the Bobby V wave, from that point. And next thing you know, that's when we began to establish our relationship, even though we went to school, but we had our own things going on and stuff like that. So that's just you know, the initial introduction. But it's funny, man. I was, you know, at that time, I did not know that. And this is a
this was question. The cat that you was going to school with. That you
yeah, I didn't know this with. Is the cat that I was going to school with, and I didn't know. That this dude I was going to school, this was the dude I was going to school with, and this dude was part of the group Mister. Oh, excuse yeah. me for being an idiot. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Yeah.
So just putting that whole thing together, man. And then like I wanted to ask you that question because you've been in the game doing your thing for so long. Chart top charts, awards, all that good stuff. And then now we taking when did you decide you wanted to wear the CEO hat and start grooming young artists up under you?
Well, I started to do it back in 2010, but I didn't have the structure. I knew I wanted to do it, but I didn't have the crew to help me put it all together, you know? So I was doing it, and I had a crew. It was called a Blue Collar. It was Blue Collar.
Shout out, Courtney.
Yeah, yeah. So yeah. It was the Blue Collar clique. And I had a female artist, and then I had like two rap guys, and I didn't have the structure in the business, you know what I'm saying? And so when you don't have that, none of it matters, you know what I mean? So now I've just kind of come to myself to know that, hey, like it's time to really do it on a larger scale and do it right and groom some new guys so that they're able to feed some families and help some people out in their lives, you know? So I'm just excited to really put that hat on just to really, take some guys from the bottom and take them to the top. And these guys definitely have the talent to do it.
So tell me about these guys. Where did you find them? What was it that gravitated you towards them? Tell me the whole process.
Well, Santon Silva was the first guy I signed. And he was brought to me by my A&R. Trail is the A&R to the label.
My guy, Trail.
Yeah, Duntrell.
Yeah.
But Duntrell is always looking for, like, new acts. And, you know, he's always like, yo, this is a dope guy. And he played me a few guys. And when he played me Santo Silva music, I was like, whoa, this is dope. And he has, like, a real pop R&B feel. Mm. And then I saw his look. I was like, wow, they both go hand in hand. So I signed him and... You know, he has so much dope music. And these guys are also self-sufficient. So once I signed him, listen to the music, another guy brought me Zan Man.
And, okay.
I love Zan Man music, and I signed him. So, you know, I'm just trying to build a crew. It's really right. A clique, man, of just real artists and musicians. And we all in the studio, and we vibing, and we just putting it down. And I think that's the best way, really, to do music, you know.
Right.
And it was just time for me to really take over that CEO hat, man. So I was
right. I feel it, bro. I feel that that's the time.
Yeah.
Been able to do that so many times. Let's go all the way back to the Mr. Days, man. Bro, I didn't even know that you were born in Mississippi.
Yeah.
I always thought you was Atlanta.
Yeah. Nah, man, my family, my mom and my dad, they're from Mississippi.
Okay.
They both from different parts of Mississippi.